Hey, this is Kev with Blender Binge, back with another tutorial for you. This time, we're gonna go ahead and make the red sun of Krypton. It's not something that's gonna really hold up inside of visual effects work, but it's cool for like motion graphics and your projects and some other stuff, whatever you can come up with. But it's a really cool way of making a kind of stylized looking sun that's really fast inside of EEVEE. Ready? Let's go. First thing I'll do is create the flares for the sun, because that's the most fun part. So the first thing I'll do is go to Shift A, and I'll add in a mesh, and I'll say UV sphere. And it comes in all faceted and kind of not cool looking. So I'm gonna go ahead and hit Control 3. And what that does is it gives it a subsurface modifier. Okay, view, and it's at level 3. Then I'm gonna give it a displacement to blow it out and make it solar. So what I'll do is I'm going to go to Add Modifier, and I'm going to go to Displace. I'm going to go to Texture here. I'm going to hit New. I'm going to hit this little button here. It says Show Texture and Texture Tab, or you could just hit this button. Doesn't really matter. And I'm going to go here, Type, Image or Movie, drop that down, and go to Clouds. Then what I'm going to do is say the size of the clouds, I'll say 0.2. Depth, I'll whack all the way up to 24, and that should be good. So now I have this blown out kind of look. And I can make it more smooth by either increasing the subdivisions, or for this purpose, I'm just going to go to Object, and I'll just say Shade Smooth. It doesn't really matter, but it just looks a little bit better. Next, I'm going to go ahead and give this a shader. So I'll go up here to shading, and it puts you into look dev mode. I don't want that, so I'm going to go over here to rendered. And I'll zoom up. And now what I'll do is I'll give it a shader. So to do that, I'm going to just go here, hit new. And I'm going to get rid of principled BSDF. And I'm going to plug it in an emission shader. So I can hit Shift A in here, or go to add, shader, emission. And I'm going to plug in emission. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to add some stuff to the emission shader to give it the texture. So I'm going to hit Control T on the keyboard, and that gives me this whole setup. Now, if you don't have this enabled, do this. Go to Edit, Preferences, go to Add-ons, up here, type in Node, and turn on Node Wrangler. Node Wrangler will let you go onto a shader, hit Control T, and get this set up right away. So that way you don't have to go and add all this stuff in manually. So next thing I'm gonna do is I have this image texture here. I don't want that. So I'm gonna get rid of that. And then I'm gonna go Shift A, and I'll add in a texture, and I'll say Musgrave, and I'll wire this up. So I'll say vector to vector, color to color. And now you see that we have a shader on here. So I'll scale this guy up, and you see he starts getting this cool kind of splotchy look. And I'll change FBM in this case to Ridged Multifractal. I kind of like that. And go with it. Next, what I'm going to do is I'm going to change the color. So to do that, I'm going to add in a control node in here, a ramp, in order to change the color. So to do that, I'm just going to hit Shift A, go to Converter, color ramp, and if I drop color ramp on top of this thing, see how it changes to white? It'll wire itself up. You just click there, boom, wires it up. So now I can go ahead and I can change this white by clicking in the white area. Change that to, say, red. We want the red sun of Krypton. There we go. And then I can change the strength here and start blowing it out. Cool. And I can go play with this and get it where I want. Next, what I can do is go over here to where it says render. I'm going to turn on bloom for EEVEE. And you can see if I turn this up now, I start getting that glow. And I can go to world over here, and I can take the gray, this gray background, and just turn it to black. And now I'm getting more of a solar kind of look. And I'm looking at this and I don't really like this. So you could play around and get something that you'd like more. Like, I don't know about FBM, hybrid, ridge, multifractal. I'm going to go ahead and change this from UV from generated to generated. And that's better. So now it's a little bit less reliant on the UV, more on just what it's generating. Turn the scale down. And ooh, if I'm animating this, it kind of gives it that sun look anyway. That's kind of cool. Okay. Next thing I'm going to do, now that I have these flares, and you're looking going, what the heck is that? I'm going to go to Shift A. I'm going to add in a UV sphere. I'm going to hit Control 2 to smooth it out, give it a modifier. And then I'm going to go and give it the same shader. So I'm going to just drop this down right here and go to Material 01. And there we go. And now I can rename these. So the one I just made, I'll call Sun. And the one that I have above it, Sphere, I'll call Flares. I can now take Sun, hit S, scale it up, and now you see the magic starts happening. We're just getting the flares poking through. Pretty cool. All right, and now we can go ahead, and if I go back here to layout and I turn on rendered, you can see that if I hit play, nothing is happening. It's not animated at all. So now we're going to go ahead and start animating the flares a little bit. And don't worry if it's not looking too perfect right now. We can clean that up later. So what we're going to do this is use a little trick to animate the displacement. Ducky3D did a really cool video on this very method, and I'll link to it in the description. So you definitely want to go check that out. But here's the quick and dirty way to do it. You just go to, we're going to add in an empty plane axis, and I'll add in a curve and a circle. And what we're going to do, I'll turn on wireframe so you can see this, is we're going to go to the empty, and we're going to have it follow around the path of the circle. And it's going to make sense in a second why we're going to do this. So to do that, I'm going to go with the empty selected. I'm going to go to constraints right here, add object constraints, and I'm going to say follow path. I'm going to go to target here, choose the path, say Bezier circle, and then I'm just going to say animate path. That's fine. So if I hit play now, you'll see that this guy is going around and around the circle. Right. And now, if I go to this flare, okay, go to the flares, and I go to the displace under modifiers, I can change texture coordinates from local to object, and then I choose the object empty. And now you'll see if I hit play, it's looping. Well, it's not really looping, but it's controlling the placement here is controlling where the displacement is happening. So to make this loop, I'm just going to go to my Bezier circle. Okay, and I showed you this in a previous tutorial too, that if you how to change the motion on a curve, if you go to object data and you go to path animation, I can now say I want this to happen in 250 frames. Or if I wanted to loop without stopping at the same place, I go 251 frames. Now you'll see that I get a nice loop. So it won't jump when it hits here. See that? So if I turn on shading now, you could see that we're getting this solar flare thing happening. And if I go over here, okay, no jump. It's a perfect loop. Cool. So now that's way too fast, right? That's not cool. I mean, if you want that look, you could keep it, I guess. But what we're going to do is slow that down. And all I have to do to slow that down is take the Bezier circle, and I'll show you in wireframe, and I just have to hit S and scale it down. So it's not traversing that much distance, but it's still a perfect loop. So now, if I hit play, these are just undulating. They're moving much slower, and they're just undulating in a loop. And if I turn this on, you can see here, from this distance, it's kind of much nicer view. So now, we're going to give just a little bit of motion to this stuff in here. So to do that, I'll go back to shading. And I'm just going to click on that to get my texture up, being that the flares and this are using the same texture. It's fine for now. And I'm going to do a little trick. Instead of animating this Okay, I've tried a number of different things, and animating this, it just kind of doesn't, it doesn't look right. So I'm just gonna give it some undulation. So to do that, I'm going to add in a mix shader in here. So I'll go Shift A, I'll go shader, and I'll say mix shader. And then what I'll do is I'll duplicate this whole thing. So I'll draw a box around here, click and drag, even up to emission, hit Shift D, and drag this down. And then I'm gonna plug emission into the second shader spot here. So I have two shaders happening, and the factor is controlling the difference between both. So one, I can change the scale of, and you see it's happening at 50%. So if I go here to factor, one or the other, right? And I can control the mix value now and just do it very subtly with something plugged into factor. Okay, so we can add in a texture to control the factor. So to do that, I'm gonna hit Shift A, go to texture, I'll choose Voronoi, all right, color to factor. And now we have kind of a mix in here, and you can see the scale, we just kind of get this kind of weird undulating effect. And we could just key this just a little bit just to add some subtle motion to this thing without worrying about the looping. So to do that, I'm gonna go over here, back over to layout. And this is one thing I don't really dig too much here. So I'm gonna go ahead and pull up another window here. Okay, just by moving my mouse over here to the extreme edge and pulling it up. And I'm gonna go to shader editor. And in here now I can see my timeline and everything else that I'm doing. And I'm gonna go here to zero. And for scale, I'll say at 3, and I'll just say insert keyframe. I'll go over out here to 251, insert keyframe. And then at, 250 frames, so at 125 in the middle here, I'll say scale 3.25. Right click, say insert keyframe. And now I have a bit of undulation happening in here. And maybe we want a little bit more than that, right? So I can go back here to 125 and really kind of pull that up maybe to 11, replace keyframe. And now you'll see we have an undulation happening here in the texture. And you'll see that it doesn't really look like it reverses or anything, and it's just enough. Now you can also go crazier here and have more of a difference in the two textures by changing Ridge Multifractal to, say, FBM. And now you're getting a much different look, more solar flares happening, and just a more interesting thing. And you'll see that as we approach the middle here, it doesn't look like it reverses itself. So it's a good cheat. And when you back out here, you can see that we have a glowing sun with some solar flare action happening and something that's pretty cool for motion graphics. So if I go to hit zero, go to my camera, all right, hit lock camera to view. You can kind of play around, and there you go. And lastly, the last thing I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna blur it out using some depth of field, okay? We're not gonna use depth of field to make everything look like, you know, a macro shot. We're just gonna use it to blur out parts of this and make it look really cool. So to do that, we're gonna add in another empty. So add, empty. This time I'll say sphere. So I could see it, scale it up, there it is. And I'm gonna go to camera, I'm gonna turn on depth of field, and that blurs it out, so you can see already we're getting this kind of nice blurred effect. And I'm gonna go to camera, camera, object data, data, and I'm gonna go to depth of field, and the focus object will be my empty 001. And I'm gonna turn the f-stop all the way down to like 0.5. And when I move my empty 001 around, all right, scale it, move it around a little bit. So let me go to transform here, pull it toward the camera. You could see here that you can kind of move it subtly and get a blur effect. So let's say like at frame one, I want it here. So what I'll do is empty O1, or I could just call this control. I'll key the location by right-clicking and saying insert keyframes. Then at say 251, insert keyframes, 125. Okay, I'll move this a little bit, maybe blur it, insert keyframes. And then now you could just kind of go around and insert a bunch of keyframes and just do it manually if you want. You could use like a noise function and stuff to do this with too, but I'm just gonna do it really quickly here. Right click, insert keyframes. And now when we hit play, okay, you'll see that you're getting a kind of blur, heat distortion. It's just a big fake, right? But it gives you some really interesting looking results. And then you could just render it out. So if I were to just go to render image, right? There's our sun. Looks a little sharp, so you could go in here and blur it out more. You could change, go ahead and change the density of this object here. So you could go to the modifier tab and you could say view, you could push this up even higher. And now when you hit render, it'll look a little smoother. And you can render it out as a movie. So let's say here I go to render, add motion blur. Let's see here. Go to temp out, folder for sun. Call this sun.mp4. Hit accept. Go to file format, PNG. Change that to FFmpeg video. Go to encoding. Change that to H.264 in MP4. And then when you hit render animation or control F12, and it'll render your animation. So I'm gonna stop here, pause the video, and come back, and we'll see the result of our sun. Okay, so here we are at the final movie. You could see that it'll hold up at a distance. You get too close, you see the squared off edges and things, but it's good for just graphic representation and a cool little style and something to throw into animations. You can always add more subdivision surfaces. You can up the subdivision resolution. You could play with the texture and really just get it to suit how you want it. And at that point, you could have the things kind of flowing off and a whole bunch of different cool things happening, but you can play around with it. So hopefully you got something out of this tutorial. If you did, hit like, subscribe, share, hit that little bell notification, and I'll keep making more. Thanks. Talk to you later. Bye.